United is what's happening 179.98 million miles away on Mars. It's time for Space News Martian Chronicle. Succeeded in its historic first flight, making it the first aircraft in history to make a powered controlled flight on another planet. 117 years after Kitty Hawk, we flew a helicopter on Mars. And as a tribute to the Wright brothers, more flights before it ends up stuck on the neighbor's roof. Wasn't a long flight. It lasted just 30 seconds and reached an altitude of about 10 feet. May not sound like a lot, but 10 feet means Ingenuity can dunk. Day because there's light at the end of the pandemic tunnel. And I'll tell you all about it in tonight's installment of The Vaccine. Half of the people are at least halfway there, and two halves makes a holy crap, we might be able to go to the movies again. Today's also the first day that all U.S. residents 16 and older are eligible for the COVID vaccine. This is a big achievement for in a star-studded event called Roll Up Your Sleeves, presented by Walgreens. It's a wonderful public-private partnership in the vein of FDR's fireside chats.
It is whispered by some that only by a band
turned out and forced to promote the vaccine, from Kumail Nanjiani and Ellen Pompeo to Amanda Seyfried and Jane Seymour. And you can trust Jane Seymour because she's a medicine woman.
To enjoy this joke, guest is Dr. Quinn Medicine Woman on Paramount Plus. Paramount Plus, a mountain of entertainment.
The headliner was former President Barack Obama. In a recent poll of Republicans and white evangelical Christians, almost 30% of each group says they will definitely not get a shot. Apparently, the message, the vaccine is safe and effective, isn't as believable as Hugo Chavez's syringe more appealing with some truck nuts. Speaking of the extreme right, it was a big weekend for a Georgia representative and woman saying, seriously, get your Frisbee off my lawn, Marjorie Taylor Greene. On Friday, we learned that Greene was organizing America First caucus that would champion Anglo-Saxon political traditions. Aye! Anglo-Saxons! Americans are losing our pre-Norman conquest culture. When was the last man? Why, when I was a child, you could borrow an oxen from your liege lord and all you had to do was some boon work in his fields. Oh, but kids today want to have their own Bluetooth oxen. It's like they never even read the village rolls or the doomsday book. Infrastructure projects, so long as they are in keeping with the progeny of European architecture, whereby public infrastructure must be utilitarian as well as stunningly, classically beautiful. Well, sure, a few on evidence of the classic European roots of with the Britons in an attempt to flee the Norse by Odin's beard. But Green's caucus was short-lived because she got a haywain of criticism, so Green called off the America First caucus following. I believe she didn't author this ode to Anglo-Saxons when dirty, backstabbing swamp creatures is literally the plot of Beowulf. What? Speaking of dirty deeds, we have a new update on an old on immigrants. This has always been a shady strategy. But one Republican's book purchases may have actually broken the law. I'm talking about Texas senator and tragic victim of pube displacement disorder, Ted Cruz. Normally, a warning to anyone visiting Ted Cruz's house. You're going to leave with a book. Also, a warning to anyone visiting Ted Cruz's house. Ted Cruz is going to be there. We have a great show for you tonight. My guests are Anthony Hopkins, writer-director.
I'm following this story of what's been happening in European football, and I know we're in America, but for the purpose of this story, I refuse to call it soccer, okay? And I know traditionally it's just a game that, like, people are playing on a park. Well, see, you're kind of right. What it is, six teams from the Premier League, three teams from Spain, two teams from Italy are going to form their own European Super League. And they've come out and they've said they're doing this, an Indian Super League, with all of the best teams who compete in it every season, sounds amazing, and it is. And the reason it's amazing is it already exists. It's called the Champions League, right? which, and what that is, if any team in Europe has a brilliant season that they've put forward, they're going to remove themselves from the Champions League and they're going to make it sort of a private club where only these self-chosen teams will really consistently be the ones that are into it. Breed I've ever seen in sport, right? Football teams in Britain, many football teams in Britain are over 100 years old, right? And these teams were started by, they were started by working class people, builders. They were built by and for the communities that they play in. They're not franchises, right? But these new billionaire owners have over the past, maybe, what would you say, 10, 12, 15 years, have been, if anything, I would say that they look at the historical fan bases of every single club with disdain, right? They want a closed shop where the rich get richer. They don't care if the teams that are below them struggle. They'll cure that money regardless of performances and regardless of success on the pitch, right? It's disgraceful. Can you imagine anything? I'm trying to think of how to describe this to...
It's like if Meryl Streep broke off and made her own Oscars.
I'd sneak in. Yes. Or something like that, yeah.
Or it's like Meryl Streep, Julia Roberts, Saoirse Ronan, and...
Viola Davis.
Viola Davis go, well, we'll always be nominated, and there's one place for someone else, but we will always be nominated. Owners about why they're doing this and why they've announced such a jaw-dropping plan. And to say during the season, when there's still, like, seven games to go, is disgusting. In their statement, three times they mentioned discarded is so that a group of billionaires can buy themselves a bigger boat or a second boat. Football is a working-class game where anyone can be anyone on their day, and it's that that makes it incredible. It's that that's the force that it is today. Like, a few years ago, Leicester City, which, Pete, have you heard of Leicester City?
Not that one.
No, right? So many of you would never have heard of Leicester City. A few years ago, Leicester City won the league. They won the bill. I don't want to be overdramatic, but I do think it's the end of the sport that we loved. It truly is. Like, I think it's going to happen, and I don't think there's anything we can do about it. But what we can do, and I hope as fans, that we will... Yeah, but I do. We'll be right back with more of The Late Late Show.
Playing a new game called What the Dub.
What the Dub?
We only take dubs here.
Well, we are missing a few people. Okay. We are missing a few people. We have... We have myself, Psydog. We have Lord Jizzle. We have Big Star, Joshua, and KSI, who is Harry.
Yes.
That's very confusing.
It's so we can still put in the thumbnail. So
Who wants to explain where Ethan is?
Ethan has the worst internet in Ethan the fucking is in East London. That's a good one.
That's
accurate,
Josh. That's JJ is? Huh? Cancelled. That's
a
title.
KSI is
cancelled. My asshole is out on camera right now.
No, it's not.
It is. I swear to God.
Oh my God! What?
So I'm
starting the game.
Welcome to What the Dub. The rules are simple. Each round, a video will play with missing dialogue.
Round one. Fight.
Round one.
Then, if I am not to be killed, why did you fire at me in the city?
Time to shake the world, kid.
Okay. You can add sound effects.
Okay. Okay. Someone said easy route.
Why did you fire at me in the city?
Potato.
Then if I'm not to be killed, why did you fire at me in the city?
England.
That was good.
Why did you fire at me in the city?
Because you're 13, why do you have a gun anyway?
You added in laughs.
Over.
You added in laughs.
Oh.
Oh,
okay.
Wow.
Check
what?
Out this last
loser. Wait, tell me, what did you put?
I put a Harry Sensitive moment.
One word.
Oh, wow. Nice. That was good.
We stink, Vic.
So many dubs, so little time. Let's get into it.
It's quite cool, to be fair.
Yeah, I like this.
Right, the time is...
The Star Trek.
It's Lady Gaga.
Nicki Minaj. Alright, Ethan, if you're in the call, help me out, yeah?
He doesn't know. You'll hear it in 10 minutes.
No, you're texting me. Oh,
that makes sense.
We need more time, lads. We need more time.
And here, give me 2 minutes.
Are they in a spaceship?
Oh, oh, it was too long.
Out of time.
Oh, no.
Look, your anus.
Oh, great.
That was good.
I love this game.
I panicked for the last 2 seconds of mine.
Look! Why is there two moons? Wait, no, it's Ethan's mum's bum.
Oh my god.
What is that? Oh, what is that?
Look! KSI is sticking a finger up his bum.
Boys, this is awful.
Favorite dumb. Cat meow.
Ow!
Oh, what?
I want a joke for Uranus.
You flipped the script on that one. Great
wow,
work.
Wow, Josh.
Oh, man.
Ow!
Sure.
Oh, bro, I've had a mind
blast. But this is hard.
Bro, I've got nothing. I've literally typed nothing.
Wait, you wrote nothing?
I literally typed nothing,
just thinking
bro.
About how a top 10 YouTuber...
What? Is that you?
Is that me, man?
Why aren't more people subscribed to Zerka? He's clearly better than Bazinga.
Pain. Oh, pain. Bro, pain.
Which dub did you like best? Vote now!
There you go.
Oh, you know what? Yeah. Think I got a stinker? I don't need no pity votes. I get real ones.
Well, that's a
yeah, I'll
take
pity votes. Give me them.
Wow. That's on my mind, lads. That's what's on my mind.
Round four.
Come on.
Show him you're not just a pretty face.
Okay.
Enter your dub.
That's what
they have said. Oh, mate, the timing is so quick.
So quick.
Better hurry.
And now you're in the...
Three, two, one.
Go on, Harry. Go on, Harry.
Huh? Oh, shit.
I don't know if you're in. You're in. You're in. You're in.
Remember what I said. Somebody told me you had a boyfriend who looked like a girlfriend that I had in fact. Remember what I said. If brown stuff comes out. Remember what I said. If there's any dead children in there, I'm calling shotgun. Come, remember what I said. Black don't crack. Always hit IT from the back.
It's IT.
Remember what I said. The Sidemen are much better than FaZe Clan.
Easy cop out. That's an easy cop out. That's an easy cop out. That's Harry. That's gotta be Harry. Feel?
I feel like I want to bust a nut in Uranus. Professor, how do you feel?
Oh, fuck's sake.
Please think. Please think.
Oh, Harry did
that. It was funny though, that was very funny.
Oh yeah, let's go!
Yeah!
And funny! You, I don't understand these last bits.
Yeah.
We all went sexual on that one.
Immaturity.
It was the vibe it was giving off. It was like some sexual tension in that room.
Hey.
Come on, bitch! Hey.
Come on!
Come on! Come on!
Oh my god!
Late game.
Wow.
Late game strong, yeah, you have to get the late game. I told ya! From early!
Well, that was interesting. That was something.
That was something.